Hi everybody, I'm Stefan for a.tatspos.com and we are going to complete our Ironman widget in this tutorial. So we are where we left over in the previous video. Let's come to this composition, let's type some titles here because I promised I'm going to type some titles. Let's increase the size of this to 15 or 18 and rotate it. By the way, the shortcut for the rotate tool is W and it's here. Just rotate it and hit T. For the opacity, set this to 25%. And for this here, I'm going to use my expression, which is this one, and just rotate the layer, duplicate it and rotate it again, change the first number to a different one, for example duplicate this, rotate it and duplicate it again and set this to 14 and this to 17 maybe, and let's create some more titles here. Set the opacity to 70%, just rotate it and duplicate it and rotate it again, duplicate it and rotate it, and finally let's create a new layer and use the digital font and let's type let's make it red in color, increase the size to 20 and let's change this to our other font that we use and let's rotate it, set this to 15 and set this to 25 for example, and just duplicate it and rotate it. And it's cool thing that you can use a couple of different fonts and font sizes on a same type layer, as you can see. Pretty cool stuff. And just make this one as well. And we are ready with the titles. Now we are going to come to our composition here and select this element and just copy and paste it here. Take the anchor point from the center and put it in the center of the element, set the scale to 50 or actually 25 or 30 and just rotate it and duplicate it and rotate it again and duplicate it and rotate it just like so. And for the type layers here, we are going to type some numbers in white color and let's paste this expression, which basically adds some random moving numbers, and set the size to 10 or in this case even 8 and set this the length from 15 to 10. This way we are going to display less numbers on the screen and then just duplicate the layer a few times, and basically that's it. I'm going to pause the video, make the rest of the duplicates, and move on to the final element. So I've duplicated all the layers, and now we are ready to move on to the final element, so we can delete the wireframe here. And yes, you need to fix these things here, but I'm going to move to the interesting part, not going to waste your time. Drop this into another composition, and as you can see, we have to create this element here. So let's set the opacity of this to 50 and select the ellipse tool and just double click, remove the fill core, increase the stroke thickness to 25 for now, and let's create the main frame. So let's set this to lower number, guess that 4 is fine, and let's call this main frame. Now let's duplicate the main frame and let's call this arch inner, and this will be this, and let's call this medium inner, and let's duplicate this and let's call this small inner, and take the arch inner, open it, let me make some room here, open the ellipse path, scale it down just a bit, increase the stroke thickness, and let's set this to 28, and let's scale it like so, better at 30, and we are going to apply trim paths modifier, and let's see, we need to make it here, and at the top part we need to make it right here, and now we are going to open this and scale down the ellipse again, increase the stroke to 40, 50, 55 maybe, and just scale it down like so, apply trim paths modifier again, and let's trim it on this side here, and on this side here as well. And for the small, we are going to open the ellipse properties once again, and let's going to scale it like so and set this to 30, 35, yes, 40 will work. Apply trim paths modifier to this and let's trim it like so. And we are ready. Now let's create a solid layer and let's call it strokes end, for example, and with the layer selected just create the ends of the strokes. Basically it's pretty easy thing to do. Sorry that After Effects can't have a different types for the strokes, and so we can save us some time doing this, but unfortunately there is no such option. Hopefully in the next versions they will add something that will help us. And final one, I guess. Let's turn on the layer, and this is the main frame. So let's duplicate, let's pre-compose it, excuse me, and let's call it GWARN main frame, and let's set the opacity to 25%. Now what we need to do is to create a new circle, set the stroke to 1 and set the ellipse to 635. And now let's find the center of our composition. Here. And let's create a shape for some of the repeating lines here, and let's call this inner thin frame, and let's call this short dashes. Let's open it, apply repeater modifier to this one, and let's open it, transform repeater, set the position to 0 and increase the number to 2 degrees and set this to 180, and then duplicate this and let's call it long dashes and select the shape, the path, and let's increase the size and open the repeater, and then divide this by 5 and open the transform repeater and multiply this by 5. So we are going to get each 5 lines, we are going to have one longer line. And now let's create the numbers. So let's do a 360 here, and let's set this to 20 for the size and position it here, and take the anchor point of the layer and let's move it in the center. Just need to set a second guide so we have the exact center of our composition, and take the point and put it there, and then just keep duplicating the layers with offsetting with 10 degrees. And as you can see, this way we are going to add all the numbers. I guess there is a smart way to do that, like an expression or something like that, but unfortunately I'm not that good with the expressions, so I don't know how to do it. And basically that's it. As you can see, it's a pretty repetitive process, so I'm going to pause the video, duplicate all the numbers and come back when I'm ready. Here we are again. I duplicated all the numbers and did the boring job, so we'll pre-comb this and let's call it GWARN numbers and set the opacity to 70%. Now let's create another ellipse circle and let's scale it down and increase the stroke to 10 here, and come to the trim paths and let's trim it and just offset it. And let's make it like so. Then we need to duplicate it and shrink the size a bit. Guess we need to increase the stroke thickness to 15 for this one. And let's play with the trim paths here and just duplicate this and offset it here, and we are going to create a solid, and let's call it strokes end. Again, select the solid and draw some shapes here as well, turn it on, and let's pre-compose this, and let's call it inner element, and just duplicate it and set it to 90. Oops, just need to offset it a bit, just like so, and set the opacity of this to 50. And now we need to create a square, so double click to create a square and shrink the size of it to 100 and set this to 5, and then with the layer selected, let's rename it center square. Let's create a line. Oops. Let's create the line here and set the thickness of the line to 1 and duplicate the shape. Open the second shape and open the transform and set it to -40, -90, and duplicate the shape and -180. This way we are going to get this, and with the shape selected we are going to draw a dash here, and let's see, this is our shape 4. We are going to apply repeater to this and open the transform repeater, zero out the position and increase the vertical position to -12, increase the number of copies to 20, and then apply a repeater and make sure that you put this repeater below everything but on top of shape 4. Open the transform repeater, zero out the position and set the rotation to -90. And this way we get this, as you can see, on a single element. So we are going to type a wiggle 1,360 to get some nice animation. And also let's create some triangles that are here. Just create this and duplicate it, and take the anchor point which is in the center of our composition for the layer, and set it here in the center of the layer and rotate it like so. And then let's create a new object, and the shortcut for no object is Ctrl Alt Shift Y, and link those triangles to no object and type wiggle 0.5,180, and this way we are going to get this animation. And finally we need to do a place for our text, so let's create the frame for the text, and let's have some fill. And now we need to open this and open the contents for it and set the fill to 25% or 15, and now let's type GWARN and let's increase this to 60, maybe 50, and put it here, set opacity for the text to 70%. And basically that's one of the elements. Here let's delete the reference image and take our final element, drop it into a new comp, and take this one and drop it into the new comp as well, because as you can see we need to scale it down and use it in our element here. So let's size it down, and I matched the size like magic, and let's reduce the opacity of the main image and just select the ellipse tool, double click, remove the fill, set the stroke to 1 in this case, and let's remove the, let's decrease, let's set the stroke to 0.5, because this way looks super thick and I don't like it. And let's reduce the size, let's apply trim path modifier and trim the shape, and you're going to see that within 2 or 3 minutes we are going to do the shape. So let's increase the size. And the rest is some basic things that are not going to take much time to create. So hopefully in this tutorial I'm going to finish the widget. And let's set the stroke like so. Duplicate the layer again and increase it. Like so, and then we have to play with the trim paths here, because it's a bit tricky. And let's see, match it like so, and on the other side like so, then duplicate the shape and just offset it to the side, and let's see like so, and then duplicate this shape again, and we need to play with the trim paths in order to match the size, and duplicate the shape again, move it like so, and let's see, we are almost ready. And duplicate the shape again, scale it down, and let's use the offset option in order to offset the element. So we are ready with this. Let's rename the layer to main frame, and now let's select the layer, and with the pen tool we are going to start drawing the shapes. So one here, and another one here, and another here, and here, and as you can see, pretty quickly recreated the element. And honestly, such a project, I thought it will take me more time to make a training about it. At first it looks like super complex, but when you break it down, into different elements, it looks more manageable. So that's the key when you work, not only when creating tutorials and stuff like that, but break it down into a lot of small pieces and then start to finish them one by one, and you're going to see that it's not that massive and hard to do. And let me see a few more. Oops, we have to be sure to click away before we select some layers. And I think we did the main frame, so let's click away and let's create the frame for the air breaker. So this is air breaker right, and this is the air breaker left, and we are going to slide it over and just open it and open the, select the path and take the top 2 points and just slide them down a bit. And now we need to select the pen tool again and let's create a shape here, make the core red, actually let's delete the shape, and we are going to do it on a separate shape layer. So first of all, let's create a shape like so. Then we are going to come to the properties and add a repeater, and then we are going to open the transform repeater and let's zero out the position, and also let's play with the transform shape. So we need to put it here and increase the number of copies to like something like so, and set the end opacity to 50%, and I guess we need to set this to 45, and just type wiggle 1,40. This way we are going to get this animation. And what we are going to do is to create a mat breaker and just create a very simple, select the rectangle mask tool, by the way using Q to switch between the masks, and create a mat for it, and let's use this as a alpha mat. As you can see, this fixes the problem, and we are going to just duplicate this and move it over. We are ready, and now we need to create some more elements here. So let's start with, I guess, this one here. Let's create a ellipse and let's make it white in color. And let's scale it down a lot. Like so. And let's take it and move it here. And scale it down more. And as you can see, we are going to use this for our frame. So we are going to trim it here and then trim it right here, and then using the pen tool just create the rest of it. if we try to add fill, it won't work. So we are going to need to create a fill layer, put it below it, create a mask here, and now let's take the pen tool and repeat the same shape and set the first to add and the second to subtract and turn it on and set the opacity to 25%, and this is how we are going to create this. Now let's create a new shape layer here for this element. As you can see, it is super easy and fast. And now we need to create the frames for the these elements here. So let's set this to 0.5 and remove the fill. And actually, let's delete the layer and start a fresh layer. And just like so, and let's call this so we know which one is which. And I'm going to organize the project once I finish the tutorials, so you can see easier what element is which element is which. And let's create the rest of the frames here. This is a easy part to do. And let's start with this one and continue with this one here. Most of the things are basic solid layers and masks and frames like so. As you can see, nothing super hard and impossible. So that's it. Now we need to create a straight line, and we are going to add a repeater. Open the transform repeater and just increase the number of copies to, let's see, 55, and then we are going to take the anchor point and put it in the center of it and hit R for rotation and just rotate and move the layer a bit, and then duplicate it and move it again. And so we need to reduce the number of copies to 52 or 53 here, and now we need to create a red rectangle and to remove the stroke, kind of like so. And we are going to add a repeater to this and open the transform repeater and play with the position. Probably set this to 15 or 18. Set the number of to negative 18 and set the number of copies like so. Set the end opacity to 50% and rotate this to negative 2.5 and let's open the transform the repeater and set the wiggle to comma 6. And then we are going to create a mat and basically just cut the shape and use is a alpha inverted mat and just duplicate this and move it over like so. And let's create some, let's take those dashes here, duplicate them and move them here and rotate them like so. And we need to open the shape and open the repeater and reduce the number of copies, and then we are going to duplicate this and move it over again and just rotate it a bit. And then let's create a solid and let's call it base. And let's start creating the base. As you can see, pretty easy thing to do. Set this to 25%. And let's continue with the shape. So we have the base and the most of the animations. We have to put some maybe a few titles. And now let's create some lines here. Let's select the main frame and using the pen tool we are going to create a line and then just duplicate it and move it over. And you can use a repeater modifier for this, but the thing is that you have to create a straight line in the middle of the composition and then offset it, and basically it will be faster, but I guess so. We can try it. So let's find the center of our composition and let's draw a line here. This is our line, and the previous four shapes we can delete them and open the line, add a repeater, open the transform repeater and zero out the position, and let's play with the rotation. And first of all we need to take the path and move it here like so, and then select the endpoint and just shorten the dashes a bit, and let's make the copies to 180 and let's set this to -2. And now we can offset the rotation. For example, we can play with the rotation like so, and maybe we can create a super simple matte layer for the dashes. So we are going to create a solid, let's call it actually we can do that because we did the dashes on the mainframe, so it's a good idea to duplicate the mainframe, and let's rename this to dashes. And basically delete everything except the dashes, and let's call this math and put it here, and let's select the pen tool and let's draw a shape. It doesn't have to be perfect, and let's use this as a alpha mat. And obviously this is not the dashes layer, so we have to duplicate the mainframe again, and I'm going to pause the video to find the dashes layer and come back. So here we are again, and here are the dashes, as you can see, and this is it for this element. We have some titles to do, and two triangles which are super easy to create. Just use the polygon tool with a red fill and a white stroke, and just let's create a triangle, possibly increase the stroke, and you can scale them down, but you need to be sure that the anchor point is in the center of the triangle. So scale it down, and you can just duplicate it and rotate it here. So that's it for this tutorial. You can duplicate the dashes and place them here using another mat, and type the titles. You saw how to do that 1,000 times in this series, so I don't want to repeat myself. And hopefully you liked the tutorials and they were interesting and useful for you, and you learned some new things. Once again, I'm Stefan for a.tuts.com, and we'll see you next time.